de France, Emmanuel Macron, hand in hand with Kolinda Grabar-Kitarovic, the president of Croatia. In the country there of Davor Suka, who 20 years ago, when France last won the World Cup, himself won the golden boot. The winner of the FIFA Young Player Award is unsurprisingly this point. Okay, Pelé was 17, he is 19, but he is barely out of school, and he is a man, a mighty, mighty man. He scored a terrific goal in the World Cup final, but long before that, he decorated this competition. If he keeps his feet on the ground and his dreams in the air, then who knows how far he can go. This could be the next big thing. He's a player, all right. And so is he. The golden ball goes to Luka Modric. And who is arguing? An award which 4 years ago went to Messi. Before that, Forlan. Before that, Zidane. Ronaldo's won it. Romario's won it. Luka Modric ran game after game. He ran mile after mile. He has his president in tears. Officially, the player of the tournament. The final wasn't his. So much of what went before was. Messi 4 years ago, he struggles to raise a smile. You understand why he didn't come here for that. Six times, as indeed James Rodriguez did for Colombia in Brazil. And the golden glove to the outstanding goalkeeper goes to Thibaut Courtois of Belgium, who of course finished third in St. Petersburg yesterday. The men understand and perhaps finally embrace the video assistant referee, to whom Nestor Pitana turned in the first half of the World Cup final, changed his mind and gave a penalty. An historic moment for which he needn't apologise to the president of Croatia. It was a matter of opinion. I must say, since the award of that penalty, I have heard strong opinions from very worthy readers of the game on either side. So you paid your money into the hole. They've done okay. And so the boys in a darkened room elsewhere. With a big heart and limitless ambition, finally got its match. Representing barely 4 million people, they punched way, way, way above their weight. They went almost the full distance, but in the final round they hit the canvas. The team which seemed not to understand the concept of defeat must finally swallow defeat. For the team with the chessboard shirt, checkmate. As the driving rain arrives, reminiscent some oracle of the 2008 Champions League final rain. French thoughts can wander back to that beautiful summer's evening of 98. To Zidane and Petit, of course, to young Deschamps too, to the magical mayhem on the shores of Ise. That derby night, no doubt to be replicated tonight. And they can reflect on that nearly night in Berlin 12 years ago, when the width of the crossbar kept them from the trophy. A dozen years and now redemption. Redemption also for those who felt Parisian pain 2 years ago, as the European Championship slipped through their fingers. They lost Europe, but now they have won the world. And they have perhaps the world's best young player. He got to lift it himself. Now he will watch his charges lifted. Pogba, for whom an iconic moment. Il cœur toujours. Sandra Fabian. Group promotion hands. They get a touch, but they do not get a hold. For the first time ever on foreign soil. For the second time in history. In the driving Moscow rain. France are the champions of the world. Almeida Les Bleus. Congratulations. So the French players can start the celebrations after a dramatic World Cup final. It's all become a bit surreal. Rain pouring down, they got ticker tape stuck to them.